I first did my cornrows because I'm terrible at doing cornrows, so I really wasn't about to show you guys the process of me doing the cornrows, but I just used a YouTube video off, I mean a tutorial off YouTube, and then I just went ahead to put this together. So this is what it looks like in the back. And then this is the hairs that I'm gonna leave out in the front. So this is kind of like my edges because I don't really have edges. And then this is my anchor braid. So this is my anchor braid. It goes all the way around like that. I just feel like I should explain this because the very first time I was doing a leave out on myself, I didn't do an anchor braid, and I feel like that's what I missed out. So it's very important to have that anchor braid just so that it gives you that, you know, positioning. And then you have the hair, you know, close enough to the hairs that you're leaving out so that it's nice and seamless. But we'll see how that goes because it's also my first time. And then this is also the hairs that I'm leaving out right here. And then I'm also leaving this much hair in the back, just because I want to be able to like hold my hair up, you know. Yeah, so now I'm gonna go in with my dome cap. I just got this from Dollar Tree and I wanted it to be black. The one that I have is brown or nude, so I wanted a black one. And this is perfect because I can literally see, you know, I can see my scalp, so it will be super easy for me to sew over this because I can see it.
Okay guys, so this next step, I'm gonna go ahead and sew the dome cap onto my cornrows. Now what this is gonna do is this basically creates a barrier and then gives me more space to sew my tracks onto, because also, you know, because my hair is thin, you know, so this just generally gives me more space so that I can be able to have enough room to sew my tracks. So I'm just gonna go ahead and sew this down, make sure that it's secured, and then I will go ahead and cut off the excess so I can have just that space. Now this next step, what I'm gonna do is just cut off the excess like I just said. I'm just gonna cut it off, and you wanna make sure that you're careful so you're not cutting your hair off, all right? Another thing that I'll do is link the YouTube video that I used for you guys down below, because I feel like she did a better job. She is actually the person who inspired me to try the sewing technique. So I cut off the excess. This is what I have. See what it looks like. And then now I'm gonna go ahead and, you know, attach my tracks.
Now this is the hair bundles that I'm gonna be using. These are kinky hair bundles from Amazon. So it doesn't have a brand name. It just says 100% human hair, but it's kinky hair bundles. It's 18 inches. So that's cool. And then it comes in 3 bundles per pack. I don't know how many of these I'm gonna use, to be very honest. But it's super soft. And the reason why, obviously the reason why I got kinky bundles is because that will match a lot better with my hair. And I even like it already. I can't wait to see what this is gonna look like. Like,
now I'm gonna go ahead and attach my tracks. I'm doubling my weft, or doubling the tracks, if you guys know what I'm talking about, just so that I don't have to cut them, and then just so that they give me that nice, you know, volume that I'm looking for. So I'm just gonna gently do this process. This step definitely takes a while because you have to be careful not to poke yourself with the pin. But again, I've been doing my hair by myself for way too long. So I'm very comfortable with a lot of the things that, you know, you would generally go to a professional to get done. I'm very comfortable doing them by myself at home. So I'm just going to go ahead and sew this onto my hair. I'm not going to lie, it was very stressful. It was a tiring process, but it was all worth it when, like, you know, I was seeing the progress. So I'm just gonna leave you guys to enjoy this part. I can't really explain too much what I'm doing, but you know, again, I will link the actual detailed video of the lady down for you, because she says what she's doing, and I learned it from her, so I feel like that would be a lot better you know, direction. So I'll link it for you down below. But I'm just doing it as per how she did it, because she has very thin hairs like mine. Like, I'm just gonna attach the tracks in the order that will fill up my hair and will also, you know, cover up my hair, just so that it's able to also sort of cover my edges in a good way, you know. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy, and then I'll be back when I have to. So I also want to say that I used about 2 bundles of hair. Yes, I think I used exactly 2 bundles. I didn't have to take anything from the third bundle. 2 bundles was perfectly fine. And I totally love the quality of this hair. I think I've said it before, or at the beginning of the video. It's literally like my natural hair. Like, when I comb it out or when I straighten or curl, it legit feels like my hair. And I'm like, I've had it in for almost a month though. You guys have seen this video like 3 weeks later, but this hair has been in for a month and it's just amazing. It's just amazing. I love it. So now I only have my anchor braid left. This is pretty much all I have left to do. And what I did in this area is I'm gonna sew this little bit of hair onto my anchor braid, but I'm going to sew it above the cornrow. So initially, all throughout the process, what I was doing is sewing the tracks underneath the cornrow, because that gives you a much cleaner you know, sew or technique or sew technique or whatever. But when you get to the anchor braid side, you obviously want to sew above. I also didn't know, so again, the lady's video is linked, but I feel like that definitely covers the track in that area really nicely, and it makes it a lot more easier for your leave out to blend in. So an anchor braid again is key. That's the thing that you need to have. You know, that cornrow that goes all the way around is key. So the cornrow technique is very, very important. Then now, this next part, what I'm gonna do is take my bonding glue. I'm just gonna take a piece of hair and then take some bonding glue and attach that very, very close to the tracks. I mean, very close to my leave out, just so that I can have that area looking a lot more fuller. And then also, you know, I just feel like I want that area to look a lot more fuller. I felt like I wanted to add a single track in that area, but I also didn't want to sew it onto the track to make it bulky. So I feel like a bonding glue technique is always the best to, you know, steal some tracks in there. So guys, this is literally the hair. You guys can see what it looks like. I'm currently taking out my leave out and just blending it to make sure that I like how it looks like. But honestly, I knew I was gonna like it, because I knew that was about the only amount of hair I was going to leave out anyway. So that should work. And I'm just gonna, you know, take out my leave out and blend it in, go to bed. It was actually really late. It was like a little over 10 at this point.
I'm so proud of myself. Like, it covers the tracks and everything so perfect. And this is my second try with doing a sew-in. It's gonna take a lot of getting used to because of my edges. But I think we'll be fine. I think we'll be fine. I'm gonna style this tomorrow, but this is what she looks like so far. So, yeah. Just gonna go to bed and then I'll come back tomorrow and style this. But this is what it looks like in the back.
Okay guys, so it's the next day and I put this in my scarves. As you guys can see, she's still nice and clean. But now what I'm gonna do is just trim this. I wanted to just bring some shape into it, you know. I like my hair to shape my face or suit my face shape, if it makes sense. So I'm always having my hair in layers because I feel like that suits my shape or my face a lot better. So I'm just gonna sort of put some layers into it, and then, you know, it makes it look cute. And then at this point, I'm just gonna go ahead and curl, just to add some volume. I think I wanted to add some curls because I think I'm a huge curl girl, you know. I'm a huge curly girl, so I just wanted to put some curls into it to see how that was gonna go. And let me just say that it holds the curls also really nicely. It holds the curl for a good amount of days. You guys know that TikTok curl that you just use the headband situation and just wrap your hair and go to bed. That is literally my favorite type of curl to do with this hair, because that type of curl holds throughout the whole day without dropping, like literally doesn't fall throughout the whole day and some. Like, I'm not even kidding. So I love this hair. I can't wait to like take it out and wash it and reuse it, because she's just such a vibe. It's just such a vibe. And at this point, I'm just going ahead to blend my hair into, I mean, the leave out into the hair. And I don't really do much. I'm not like using a lot of products and whatnot. I'm just like straightening my hair on the lowest heat possible and then blending it with like a brush. I'm using a brush, a chaser brush, because I feel like that will chase pretty much all the strands into the kinky hair. So and then the next thing that I'm gonna do is actually a step that I want to share with you guys. So this is my Magic Roots cover up from L'Oreal. I'm sure you guys have seen this over the counter in like Walmart or something, but it's really good if you have thin edges and you are very insecure about it. You can just spray that down and it gives you, you know, sort of like a temporal cover up for a few days, especially if you have a leave out like that. I feel like that really works. I totally love how this turned out. Comment below, let me know what your vibe is, if you're feeling it, because I definitely am. At this one, I was asking my husband what he thinks. I was telling him if my edges didn't look bad, and he's like, obviously my husband is not gonna say that they look bad. So yes, it looks cute. I did some cute little makeup for my Instagram, and yeah, this is the final look. Comment below, let me know what you think. All right, and if you happen to ever try this, let me know also. I will link the hair for you guys. And I love you. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.